Welcome back to another ORM Mastery tutorial. Don't forget you can access all the tutorials in this course. There is a link in the video description. And of course, if you love this course, then you can go ahead and use our link in the video description to get the best price for our Udemy course. Well, hopefully we've now suitably refreshed our knowledge of many-to-many. Let's now turn our attention to explicitly specifying a many-to-many intermediate model. Ultimately, we simply just need to tell Django that we no longer want it to create its own intermediate model and that we want to specify our own. So the first step is to create a new through model. That's a model that we're going to be then utilizing as our new link table or intermediate model. So the same process as when defining a many-to-many field, we need to define our many-to-many field on either side of the relationship. But remember, only one side of the relationship needs to be defined. So the first argument, the mandatory argument in the many-to-many field, is the class to which the model is related. And here, simply to override Django's default behavior of creating a many-to-many table, or sorry, a many-to-many intermediate model, we simply need to define the through option. So if you take a look at the documentation, there are a number of different extra arguments that we can pass into the many-to-many field. Through is one of these. Let's go ahead and create a new class or new model. This is going to be our link or intermediate table. Here we've named this class product category. Now it's entirely up to you how you want to name this class, but we recommend that utilizing the name of the two tables that we want to develop a relationship between, in this case, seems like a suitable approach. Because we are going to build a relationship, then we're going to need a way of building a connection between this new link table and the category and product table. So we define two foreign keys, one over to the product table, and then the second over to the category table. We will need to define, because it's foreign key, the on-delete option. Here we've just selected cascade, but of course it depends on your particular business requirements. Now I do recommend, if you haven't already solidified your knowledge of the on-delete options, that you just remind and recap each and every time you need to when developing a model. It can have serious ramifications, the different options that are available, and will potentially affect the data integrity in certain situations. In addition to the two fields that builds the connections, the many to one connection over to the individual models, you may also want to supply a primary key, although the behavior, the default behavior, Django will automatically create a primary key like it does with all the other models for this particular link table intermediate model. So to override the default settings of Django creating a many-to-many table, here in the product table we have our existing many-to-many field. We simply need to change or add a different property here, and that's to utilize the through. So here we're simply defining or telling Django the fact that if we want to access the category, and of course we can call this whatever we like, but utilizing the word category clearly identifies potentially where it is we're building a relationship or what we're building a relationship to. So in order to build a relationship to the category table, utilizing a many-to-many relationship, then we need to connect to the model that we want to build a relationship, and we need to then tell Django which table to go through in order to get to that table or model. And that's the through option here. So here we define product category, which is of course the name that we've defined to our new link table here, product category. So let's put this into action. I'm going to just delete the existing database, and then we'll go ahead and make sure that we removed any of the migrations. So avoid removing the init file here or anything else. So make sure we move the three files here if you have those available in the migration. This code is available. You can download this code example. Okay, so now we've deleted those migrations. Let's just go ahead and make migrations. Make migrations. There we go. Okay, so error, product is not defined. So we do have an issue here. because I think what's happening here, you can see, is that we're trying to define a class that hasn't been defined yet. So we're going to need to move this class. Let's put it underneath the products table, and that will then be able to find the product and category table. So let's just run this again. There we go. So now we've moved our link table below the two classes or models, product and category, that we've defined or called here in our new product category intermediate table. Everything has now been migrated. So let's go ahead and migrate. And then we'll just check out our new table. So this is the SQLite extension, remember, that we've installed to be able to view this. So we can see at the bottom here, we now have a link table, the inventory product category table. You can see that Django has created the primary key for us, and then we have the two foreign keys that we've defined in our model. The current link table that we've developed, potentially there is an issue here in that we can duplicate data in our table. Potentially we have a redundancy issue in our new link table. We now have three fields in our new link table: the automatically created ID, primary key, product ID, and category ID. Take, for example, we were to enter some new data into this table. In this instance, we insert into our table product ID 1, category 1. So here we've built a relationship between product ID 1 and category 1. What if, for example, we were to accidentally build a new relationship between product ID 1 and category 1? Well, that would be, in the current setup, be possible because the unique and primary key is the ID field. What we end up with here is duplicated data in our database. Here in our link table, we define class meta and we create unique together. And we define here the fact that the product ID and the category ID field together should be unique throughout the whole table. Now that we've defined the fact that product ID and category ID fields are unique together, whenever we go ahead and now try and insert a second row with a similar product ID and category, that will now not be possible.